And we are back here on the GSMC Football Podcast. And for the second part of the show, we're going to talk about the Chiefs and the Raiders yesterday. Raiders pulling off the upset. They were 10.5-point underdogs, then it went up to 11.5. I mean, for yesterday's games, I thought, you know, listen, the Chiefs are going to blow out the Raiders. Eagles are going to blow out the Giants. And then the Ravens are going to cover, and I'm going to go 3-0. Well, that wasn't the case. I ended up going 1-2 again on the holidays. Raiders winning 20-14 and without scoring an offensive touchdown. The Chiefs, listen, and they have the tendency to do this. And I feel like in a year like this where your offense is struggling, you can't lollygag. And that's what they did yesterday. On two plays. Not two plays, but one. They fumbled, which then led to a touchdown, where you had Isaiah Pacheco taking the direct snap, Mahomes coming over, and there, I guess, I mean, it was just miscommunication there, because I guess, I mean, was Pacheco supposed to keep it and run with it? Because he did do that on another play, and that was for the touchdown. I mean, it wasn't like the same exact play that they were running, but Pacheco, like, faked it, and then he just ran, and then he ran it in. But this one, I guess, Pacheco was supposed to keep it and then run, and instead they ended up fumbling the ball. Raiders picked it up, scored a touchdown. So that made it 10-7, well 9-7. Then they kicked the extra point, and then actually they did miss the extra point. Did they miss the extra point? Well, regardless, Then the Chiefs throw a pick six. Mahomes throws a pick six on the next play by Jones. So, regardless, it was a 10-point game. I mean, it was just on back-to-back plays. And then you have Butker. So, the Chiefs goes 13 plays, 57 yards down the field. And then Butker misses a 36-yard field goal. So if you want it now, I just told you how much I lost by in my fantasy matchup. If Butker makes that kick, then we're having a different conversation. So the Chiefs then go into the half down 10. Raiders punted. Chiefs turned it over on downs. Both teams punted again. Raiders kicked another field goal. Chiefs turned it over on downs. Fourth quarter comes. There was only three possessions. Raiders punted. Chiefs then go down the field. 9 plays, 69 yards. Mahomes connects with Justin Watson for a 7-yard touchdown. So that makes it 20-14. And then the Raiders just keep the ball the rest of the way, and they're able to win it. Zamir White had a couple of big runs in this game, and again, same thing with the fantasy matchup. My friend had Josh Jacobs. He had to start Zamir White instead, which I thought was going to be beneficial, and it ended up not being the case because he ended up having 145 yards rushing on the day. But yeah, the Raiders didn't score an offensive touchdown. AidenO'Connell only went 9-21 for 62 yards. No touchdowns, no picks. Zamir White, like I said, 145 yards rushing on 22 carries. Jacoby Myers was their leading receiver. He had 3 receptions for 42 yards. Then on the Chiefs side, Mahomes went 27-44, 235 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 pick. They actually did a fake punt that was successful. Tommy Townsend, an 11-yard pass, and I think that was to Justin Watson. Isaiah Pacheco actually left the game with a concussion, but he had 26 yards rushing and a touchdown. The Raiders defense did a great job in this game. Rashee Rice was their leading receiver. He had 57 yards. Richie James had a 45-yard reception. He had 54 yards in total. Travis Kelce had 5 for 44. Justin Watson had 4 for 38. Edwards-Helaire had 3 for 42. But yeah, Mahomes, he did fumble, but he didn't lose it. Pacheco got charged with the fumble on that direct snap play. Chiefs had a couple of sacks in this game. The Raiders actually had 4 sacks in this game. Malcolm Kuntz, I think that's how you pronounce it. He had 3 sacks in the game, and then Adam Butler had 1. I mean, the Raiders defense did a great job in this game. I mean, credit to them. Credit to Antonio Pierce, really. I mean, this team, you know, from how it started to how it's going, I mean, you know, listen, they're probably not making the play. I mean, listen, they can still make the playoffs, but they probably aren't going to. But credit to Antonio Pierce and what he's been able to do. I mean, listen, they lost 3-0 to the Vikings. They should have won that game. I'm looking at their schedule now. But you only lost by 7 to the Dolphins. You were up against the Chiefs in Vegas, but they weren't able to hold on to that lead. And then you lose 3-0. I mean, ever since he's taken over, this team, it's looked like a different team. The defense, I mean, getting turnovers, pick sixes. I mean, they just put up 63 points against the Chargers. Listen, he deserves to get that job. And they got two winnable games coming up. They could finish with a winning record. They could. Now, I think they need a quarterback. You know, Aiden O'Connell has had his moments, but I don't think he's the guy. I mean, I think you give him a chance to be the guy, but I think you got to bring in another quarterback. You know, through the draft or whatnot. But, yeah, I mean, they still have a chance. I mean, it's going to be tough because you got the Colts and then the Broncos at home. But they got a shot to finish with a winning record. They definitely do. I mean, and also Zamir White. You know, the times that he's filled in for Josh Jacobs, he's done a nice job, especially yesterday. I mean, rushing for over 140 yards on 22 carries. Again, at the expense of my fantasy season, but he did a nice job, you know, without Josh Jacobs. And the defense, two turnovers, they capitalized. And the Chiefs just could not get anything going. I mean, there's miscommunication with the receivers. You got Travis Kelce throwing his helmet. And then they're going to bring it back to him, and Andy Reid stopped them from getting it back to him. And, you know, he kind of shoved Kelce a little bit because he was getting on him for doing that. But, yeah, the Chiefs are in disarray right now. And, yeah, I mean, they look like a team that could be one and done in the playoffs, honestly. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen. I mean, I think they'll at least win one. I think they should at least win one playoff game. But this just does not look like their year. There's a lot of problems with them. But you know what? Listen, they've been good, you know, every year since Mahomes has entered the league. I mean, they're due for at least one bad year. And I mean, listen, they should still get into the playoffs. And host a playoff game. But, I mean, even so, like, it just, their offense is struggling right now. Again, they really couldn't run the football yesterday. Pacheco gets hurt. And they were already without Jerry McKinnon. So, you know, they're kind of shorthanded there. And you know, the receivers, I mean, Rashee Rice has been good, but that's really about it. You know, Valdez-Scantling, Sky Moore, Kadarius Toney was out yesterday. They're struggling on offense. And when you get to the playoffs, I mean, listen, you got the Browns, you got the Bills now who are in a playoff spot. We'll see who gets the final wild card spot. But, I mean, if you got to go up against one of those teams in the first round, I mean, look at how Joe Flacco's playing. Again, they picked up another win against the Texans. But even the Colts, too. Colts got a good running game. Now, again, you got Gardner Minshew at quarterback, who's played well, but again, you know, you're going to go up against a tough team, you know, as a 3 seed. Because I think right now, you look at, you know, who's in the wild card right now, and you look who's in the wild card right now. So you got the Browns, the Bills, and the Colts. Texans are one game back. Steelers are one game back. Bengals are one game back. You know, I think the Texans get that final spot. If Stroud comes back. If Stroud doesn't come back, then that's different. But, you know, we'll see. It's probably going to come down to the Colts and the Texans because, I mean, I don't know what happened to the Bengals on Saturday, but now that you got the Steelers still in the conversation, But again, it's going to be a dogfight to the end. And then you got the Raiders at 7-8, still technically in it. Broncos are 7-8. You know, we'll talk about that game at some point this week, probably tomorrow. I mean, the Chiefs, well, right now they'd be going up, right? They'd be going up against the Bills, right? Yeah, they'd be going up against the Bills again. And, I would not favor the Chiefs in that game. Now, the Chiefs, I mean, you know, if Kadarius Toney doesn't line up offsides, odds are they end up winning that game. Definitely not going well for them right now. And we'll see. I mean, are they going to... I mean, listen, earlier in the year I said, they'll turn it around, because that's what they do. They hit these skids, but then they're able to ultimately figure it out. But, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough. We've got a chat, and it's from Andrew Tate, who is a big part of the GSMC Sports Network. And he says, I would take the Bills over the Chiefs. And yeah, I would do the same thing, because now the Bills have their issues too, with a lot of guys injured on defense. But, I would still take them over the Chiefs. I mean, Josh Allen's playing better. James Cook, I mean, had that monster game against the Cowboys. Not the same thing against the Chargers. He fumbled in that game. I mean, the Bills almost lost on Saturday against Easton Stick and the Chargers. But, I still right now would take the Bills. But that's right now what it's lined up as is the Bills and the Chiefs, you know, in the first round if it stays like this. Because right now the Dolphins have the 2 seed. So we'll see. And listen, I wouldn't say no to another Mahomes-Allen playoff game, but it probably end a little bit differently the way these teams are kind of heading. So we'll just have to wait and see. But before we go into our second break of the show, once again, I just want to remind you guys, as always, to tip or donate and get your comments recognized, make sure to go to the following link. That is streamelements.com/GSMCSportsNetwork.tip. Again, that really helps the show, makes the show more interactive between myself, the host, and you guys, the viewers. Again, that is streamelements.com/GSMCSportsNetwork.tip. And as always, this is displayed on the ticker on the bottom of the show segment down below. So when we get back from our second break of the show, we'll talk about the Eagles-Giants game from yesterday. Eagles, if you want to call it getting back on track, well, that's what I'm calling it, getting a win, even though it wasn't pretty. Ending their losing streak. So that is what we'll get into when we get back from our second break of the show. So stick around, and we'll be right back here on the GSMC Football Podcast.